biggest days are going to be in this history, George Bush. Now he's no longer there. George Bush,
I'm
number one. Sorry?
I'm with you on that.
You're with me on that. So I'm also going to America. I'm even going to America live and on satellite, giving the message to Americans. I was the first person that I know of in the public after 9/11. In Australia, I said, I'm a fundamentalist and I consider George Bush to be the biggest terrorist. It came at headline. In December 2001, when I gave a talk in Australia, when the consul general asked me, that what do you consider, who's a terrorist? I said, George Bush number one. It came as headline, Dr. Zakir Naik calls himself a fundamentalist and considers George Bush to be terrorist number one. Now, every Tom, Dick and Harry is calling him a terrorist. At that time, no one had the guts. What we realized, we are speaking the truth. Now, whether George Bush, you know, many people said, and I gave a talk in London on terrorism. Very good talk, people enjoyed. A youngster comes and says, death to George Bush, death to George Bush. Full talk of mine God. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad, there were two staunchest enemies of Islam. Both were called Umar, Umarain. The Prophet prayed to Allah that give hidayah to one of these two Umar. And Umar bin Khattab, who was the second of Islam, Allah gave hidayah, who was the staunchest enemy of Islam, became the staunchest supporter. Therefore, I said, may Allah give hidayah to George Bush. I cannot give hidayah. I can tell him what he's doing is wrong. I don't want to kill him. I want him to accept Islam. Killing is useless. What thing is of killing? Accepting is better. So that's the reason we are giving the message. Those whose hearts are open to accepting, inshallah, God will open your heart also one day. When God opens your heart one day, I cannot do it. I can give the message. I can't force you. Unless you strive. If you strive, God will help you. If you don't strive, your heart will not be opened. Some people ask questions only for questioning. That's a question which they get. But the true gentleman, Bharat ke bachcha, wo hai. So when he accepts, when he gets the answer, he accepts it. You know, people just ask for questioning. A question which they get. You spoke very loudly. I am asking why I gave a speech. I said so many things. Do you agree with it or not?
Yes, I agree with it.
Are you a Hindu?
I'm actually your favorite. I'm an atheist.
Atheist?
Atheist.
You're my favorite.
No, I'm not your friend, but I was told that you like having debates with such.
Yes, atheist. Okay, brother. You're an atheist. Fine. I would like to congratulate you.
You'd like to what?
I would like to congratulate you. You know why?
Right.
You're asking, you're asking.
The reason
I complain you because all the other, you know, all the human beings are blindly following. Father is a Christian, the son is a Christian. His parents are Hindu, he's a Hindu. Many of the Muslim parents are Muslim. You are thinking. I know their father was atheist. Father was atheist? No. Good. We are thinking. Because you're thinking now, when you go to the people, they worship the Almighty God who falls down and breaks. So you are teaching, and the reason I congratulate is because you have said the first part of the Islamic Shahada, La Ilaha, there is no God. You have already said half the Kalma.
But not the second part.
They have said the full Kalma, you are half Muslim now. It just means half Kalma, you know, La Ilaha. Only thing you have to do is Illallah but Allah, which I shall do inshallah. I'm congratulating you because you have agreed that to the other people who believe in wrong God. These days, Ram, first I have to spend half my time in trying to convince them the God you are worshipping is wrong. You have already agreed there is no God. Only thing you have to do is prove to your God, Allah, which I shall do inshallah. Brother, suppose there is equipment which is bought. Equipment is bought in front of you. Who no one in the world has ever seen. No human being has seen this in front of you. And if I ask you the question, who is the first person who will be able to tell you the mechanism of that equipment?
I heard this speech and it's the creator.
It's the creator, fine. So the creator of that equipment will be the first person who will be able to tell you the mechanism of that object. You may say creator, you may say manufacturer, you may say inventor, you may say maker, whatever it is, somewhat similar. Now I'm asking you a question. How did this universe come into existence? How did the universe come into existence?
You are going to now mention the Big Bang and all.
No, I'm asking you.
Yeah.
Don't tell me what I'm going to mention. I want to know what is about. No, you are a thief. I'm asking you according to your knowledge.
No, the thing is, I've actually heard this speech before. I'm actually a good fan of yours, you know that.
Mashallah, you're a good fan. Good fan, theoretical or practical? If you're a practical fan, you'll follow. If I'm wrong, you correct me. If I'm right, you join me.
No, I only learned about you about 2 weeks back, actually.
Point, in 2 weeks you became a great fan. Mashallah, I'm very happy about it. In 2 weeks you learn about me. That means you know. You know about the creation, the Big Bang,
yes,
which we
yes.
came to know recently. Quran Mesh is 14 years ago in Surah Ambiya, chapter 21, verse number 30. Awalam Yal Nadina Kafaru.
And the verse is
fine. But you know that.
Yeah.
Similarly, we did not know that the earth was spherical. We came to know recently. Quran Mesh is 14 years ago in Surah Nadia, chapter 7, and verse number 30, it is spherical. We thought first the light of the moon is old light. Quran Mesh is 14 years ago, the light of the moon is not its own light, reflected light, which came to know recently. Who could have mentioned this? There is biology, there is water cycle which you learned in school, there is embryology, there is genetics. My question, who could have mentioned all these things in the Quran? So if you have heard this, you also know the answer. Who could have mentioned in the Quran? Same answer.
The Creator.
This Creator who has mentioned in the Quran, we call it Allah. So that means you believe in the Creator. Who could have mentioned this in the Quran? The Creator. The Creator who created the human beings, the person who created all this universe. It can't be a human being who writes all this. So now do you believe in a Creator?
Well, there are different perspectives, you see, a person has.
Perspective will discuss
later on. Science, or you can think about God. Now the debate is which to follow.
Oh, we can follow both. I believe in both.
I am a student of science also.
Also, I am a believer in God.
As my opening question stated, what I asked about terrorism, I believe you also know those are certain facts.
Brother, we'll come to terrorism later on.
Yeah. We're talking about
brother,
that.
Brother,
why
brother,
I don't
brother, believe. Brother. You ask me direct question, you start bombing, killing innocent, wrong, I give direct answer. I am asking you direct question, you give me direct answer. You ask me, you are happy with my answer. No beating around the bush. I am asking you directly, when you believe in the Creator, why don't you accept the Creator? I am asking you directly. You ask me direct question in front of 30,000 people, I give a direct answer. I am asking you a direct question. You didn't believe in God, I congratulated you. Now I prove to you that the Creator wrote the Quran. I am asking the question, why don't you believe in the Creator?
I didn't say that I believe in the Creator.
No,
I was just
the Creator.
Mimicking your speech.
Oh, I didn't ask. Brother, I didn't ask you to come here to mimic me, please. Did I ask you to come and mimic me?
No.
I asked you, who wrote, you said Creator. I didn't say, did I say that?
No, but that's
even
what,
my speech, I don't say.
That's what you said.
Even I didn't say, the questioner said, that means you haven't seen my speech correctly. Like how you are telling, when I ask and yes, he gives the reply Creator, not I. That means I haven't seen my speech correctly. It is a person like you, who I might have asked the question to, he gave the reply.
Yeah.
Like how you gave the reply now. Did I ask you to mimic or did I ask you to give answer from your heart? So that means you are not a very truthful person, huh?
No.
You ask me a question, brother. I give answer directly. From my heart, correct?
Yes.
I am asking you a question, you gave the answer, now you are saying that I am mimicking. What is? Do you believe there is God and he has no images? Do you believe there is one God? And do you believe Prophet Muhammad is the messenger of God?